Good morning, Roja City! Good morning to the learners and campus journalists of the school's division of Roja City. So before we formally start our activity this morning, let me first acknowledge the key personnel of the school division, the school's division of Roja City, starting with the Assistant School's Division Superintendent, Officer in Charge, Office of the School's Division Superintendent, Mr. Feliciano C. Buenafe Jr., CESU 6. Let me acknowledge to the Assistant School's Division Superintendent, Mr. Rogelio P. Amador. Same acknowledgement is also given to the Chief Education Supervisor of the School's Governance and Operations Division, Dr. Narisa A. Recente. We would like also to acknowledge the Chief Education Supervisor of the Curriculum Implementation Division, Dr. Marvic S. Martirez. We would like also to acknowledge the Administrative Officer 5 of the School Division Office of Roja City, Mr. Ariel Andutan. And also, we would like to acknowledge the focal person of journalism, the Education Program Supervisor in English, Dr. Evelyn Cercado. Also, we would like to acknowledge the co-focal person of journalism of the school's division of Roja City, the Education Program Supervisor in Filipino, Mrs. Renita Bocalid. Same acknowledgement is also given to the President of the Division Association of the School Paper Advisors of in English, we have Mr. Mark Julius Fuentes. Also, same acknowledgement is given to the President of the Division Association of the School Paper Advisors in Filipino. We have Ma'am Lourdes Orola. So, we'd like also to acknowledge our competent learning facilitators for this activity. Campus journalism plays a vital role in nation building, especially in this time of pandemic. And we believe that we need to capacitate you, our learners, to become more responsible and just campus journalists. And we present to you the webinar on exploring the digitalization of the school publications workshop for school's editorial staff. So at this moment, let's hear the message of our Assistant Schools Division Superintendent, Mr. Rogelio P. Amador.
To our competent schools division superintendent, Sir Feliciano Buenafe Jr., to the equally competent chiefs of the two functional divisions, Dr. Marvic Martirez of the CID and Dr. Neresa Recente of the SGOD, division personnel, school leaders, teachers, beloved learners, good morning. There were a lot of skepticism as to whether schools will open this school year. Thanks to our education leaders and most especially to our teachers who supported the move, we have successfully opened in October 5. We are in an exceptional time and we need to perform exceptional actions. We do not want that learning will be put to a stop just because we are facing a serious health concern. Definitely, we place the health and safety of our personnel and learners as the topmost priority, but this should not bar us from employing alternative means for the benefit of our learners. As our Deputy Secretary had emphasized, education must continue even in this time of pandemic. We salute our teachers who continue to find extraordinary ways in order for learning to happen despite the odds. This three-day webinar workshop is a proof of our teachers' ingenuity. You never run out of good ideas for the good of our learners. At this point in time, having our school publication digitized is the best option. In this way, we will be able to hone the writing skills of our student journalists without compromising their health and safety. Good luck to our participants. In spite of the big challenge posed by this new normal situation, I am certain that with the cooperation of everyone, we will be able to make things happen. My congratulations to the organizers and facilitators of this activity. Good luck, everyone, and may God bless us all.
Thank you so much, Sir Amador. So I know you're all very excited for this morning's activity. So before that, let's have first an orientation to be given to us by the president of the school, Division Association of the School Paper Advisors. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Mr. Mark Julius Fuentes.
Good morning, school paper advisors and the campus journalists all over Rojas City, and specifically from the schools division of Rojas City. So welcome to the webinar on exploring the digitalization of the school publications. This is a workshop for schools editorial staff. And we have this two-day conference, virtual conference, basically. And for day one, we shall be having four topics. These are first the news writing, which comes after the orientation I'm doing now. The second is the editorial writing. Third is the feature writing. And lastly, the copy reading and headline writing. On the second day, that is tomorrow, we will be having first the sports writing, followed then by the science and technology writing, then photojournalism, and lastly, the editorial cartooning. So if you can observe, we do not have any conference with group competitions or categories involving group competitions, because you know this year we will only be having individual events. And for that, I'd like as well to orient everybody that each talk comes with an activity which everybody has to outdo, meaning to say every topic which is being handled and supervised by each speaker, they will be each giving you an activity later on which you really have to submit your outputs. The submission of your output serves as your secondary registration to your key in joining the Division Schools Press Conference. So now, speaking of the upcoming Division Schools Press Conference, that is the first virtual ever in history, the Division Schools Press Conference, and these are the guidelines. I'd like everybody to take note of the guidelines of the following. First, we have news writing or pagsulat ng balita. So in the event earlier, you have been required to register yourselves through Google Form, the category you will be joining in. So you can see in there categories in two media. We have English and we have in Filipino. So in English, news writing is the term being used if you are for it. And in Filipino, we'll have pagsulat ng balita. So this particular of the terms, if you are for English, then choose the appropriate English term of your contest you are joining in, then the Filipino for the other. So now, let's go back to the orientation for news writing. But before that, I'd like again to announce that our upcoming Division Schools Press Conference will be on March 2 and 3 for the elementary, and then March 4 and 5 for secondary. Now, news writing guidelines. Prepare for any news writing approach and angling. It could be in a live press conference, virtual opening program like this. It could be interview video clips and relevant data from local news which the examiner shall be giving you. Next, official downloadable DSPC writing test paper shall be provided. This can be taken from the registration link 1 hour before the competition. Third, There shall be two links to be generated on the day of DSPC. One, for registration, which contains the downloadable official DSPC writing test paper. And one, for the submission link, which shall accept the contest entries of the contestants. Next, only one page is allowed for writing events. Next, manual handwriting is strictly required. No digital or computer-generated documentary input system shall be used. Once done, the contestant can submit it in an image file, either taken from a mobile camera or through digital scanner. Be sure to submit your entry in the clearest way possible. So we will still be applying the standards for writing, meaning to say, once you have downloaded the official writing test paper of the SPC, still you will be writing manually with your handwriting, of course, through the paper given to you. And then when you are done with your writing, you have either to scan it after printing it, or you can, you know, take a photo of it in an image form and then send it to us. Next, black ink shall be used for your writing entry. Contestants may write in print or cursive. Next, 2 hours shall be allotted during the day of competition for each writing category. This shall cover the downloading of official DSPC writing test paper, the contest proper, and the submission of the output or the official contest entry. After time limit given, the system automatically closes. So again, each of the contestants is being given 2 hours that shall contain or shall enclose the preparation or the downloading of the test paper, the writing process, and then the submission of the contest entries. Next, along with the submission of your contest entry are your 3 authentication photos and 1 10-second video clip while writing your title or headline. This shall serve as basis for handwriting recognition's consistency. So, meaning to say, hindi lang ang inyo output ang inyo nga i-submit. So, may ala kita 3 ka photos nga aton nga i-send. Kag isa nga video nga 10 seconds lang gid. Ano ang makit-an sa photo number 1? Photo number 1 shall be close-up shot showing the contestant facing the camera while holding the official DSPC writing test paper. So pagkatapos niya download sang iyang test paper, no, mapapicture sa sina holding it empty. Photo number 2. Photo number 2 shall be close-up shot showing the contestant while writing. So samtang nagasulat ang contestant, maybe in the middle part of his or her writing, dapat may ala kita close-up shot nga makit-an ang bata nga nagasulat, nga makit-an ang iyang sinulatan, partial of sang iyang write-up. Photo number 3 shall be close-up shot showing the contestant holding the finished entry. So pagkatapos niya sang iyang pagsulat, so mapapicture siya, close-up shot nga holding the finished entry. And then lastly, ma-upload ka mo sang 1 video file which is 10-second close-up video clip while writing your title. So dira sa aton nga title, dira sa aton nga video clip, ipakita dira ang bata nga nagasulat sang iya nga title or headline if you are for copy reading. Dira naton mabalan if the this shall serve as basis for handwriting recognition and consistency. So okay, next, contest topic shall be given upon registration. So once you are registered, ara na dira dayon ang topic. Some can be seen in the uppermost part of the official DSPC writing test paper, while others in a separate sheet or sheets as needed. Google account must be secured and activated as this serves as your identification for the competition. So you really have to secure with you your Google account. And now proceeding to editorial writing or pagsulat ng Pangulong Tudling. First, prepare for any editorial writing approach taken from a live press conference, documentary video clips, and relevant data from the latest news. So still, mayara kitang downloadable DSPC writing test paper shall be provided. And this can be taken from the registration link 1 hour still before the competition. Now, para use man sang sa news writing, manual handwriting kita, no? It can either be in cursive or in print. Kung ano ang nag-a-apply sa news writing, the same thing goes to through all writing events or competitions. Now, the same man, tatlo ka photos. Photo number 1, samtang atubang ang contestant sa camera while holding the official DSPC writing test paper. Second, showing the contestant while writing. Third photo, close-up shot showing the contestant holding the finished entry. And lastly, the video file, 10 seconds magyapon while writing the title. Okay. Next, feature writing or pagsulat ng lathalain. The same thing man. Prepare for any feature writing approach taken from a documentary video clips and or relevant data from the latest news, magazine shows, or any topic the examiner shall supply. So the same guidelines apply for this category. Proceeding to sports writing. Okay, may mga little differences lang kita with sports writing or pagsulat ng sports. So in here, still, may 2 links kita for the registration and the submission, and then 1 page only is allowed for writing your sports story, manual handwriting man gihapon in black ink. Pero be mindful of this. Okay, take note of this. Sports writers will be given 3 hours. Okay, 3 hours shall be allotted during the day of competition for sports writing category. This shall cover the downloading of official DSPC writing test paper, the viewing of the live sports coverage and the data note-taking, the contest proper, and the submission of the output or the official contest entry. After time limit given, the system automatically closes. So you won't be notified if any signaling you that your competition is about to end, because you yourself has to be time conscious with the given time allotted to you. So many can say you have to secure with you, okay, beside you, your wristwatch perhaps, or your cell phone containing 8 time segments for your competition and whatnot. Next, the same man, may ara kita photos 1, 2, and 3, the yun 1 video file, samtang nagasulat ikaw sang title. Now, for science and technology writing or pagsulat ng agham at teknolohiya, the same ang gihapon in all writing events, except lang sa sports, no, kagkapi reading, ang sa science, the same man. So, may ara man kita 2 links, and then, ang isa ka link sa submission link, kagang isa for the downloading and registration of the official DSPC writing test paper. So manual handwriting man gihapon using black ink, and contestants may still write in print or cursive. But still, 2 hours shall be allotted during the day of competition. So 2 hours ni siya ang ihatag sa tagsa-tagsa ka mga contestants. And after time limit given, the system automatically closes. Again, I'd like to reiterate that the time allowance, the 2 hour time allowance, includes everything. The downloading of the test paper and the registration, your writing proper, and the submission of your output. Still, you have photos, 3 photos to submit to us. 1 with you before the competition, Photo number 2, showing your contestant or showing the contestant while writing. Photo number 3, close-up shot showing the contestant holding the finished entry, and one video file containing 10-second close-up video clip while writing your title. So now, let's proceed to copy reading and headline writing. So the same man gihapon, we have to copy reading and headline writing is also called pagwawasto ng sipi at pag-uulo ng balita in Filipino. We have to prepare applying copy reading marks and instructions from a downloaded file document containing erroneous news to be provided by the examiner. So the same man, wala man sang pagbago, except that in your competition, you shall be using pencil for making corrections. Okay? The same ang gihapon sa mga photos na inyo isubmit along with your entries. Next, in photojournalism. So, dire sa dumidyo, damo kita dire changes. So, I'd like you to take note of the guidelines for the photojournalism contest category. Photojournalism or pagkuha ng litratong pampamahayagan. First, prepare for any photojournalism techniques from data to be provided by the examiner. Number of photo requirement and other relevant instructions shall be disclosed upon registration. This can be taken from the registration link 1 hour before the competition. Next, there shall be 2 links to be generated on the day of the SPC. One for registration, which contains the downloadable official DSPC writing test paper or contest instructions for photojournalism, and one for the submission link. Next, 3 hours shall be allotted during the day of the competition for photojournalism. This shall cover the downloading of official DSPC writing test paper or instructions. Next, the contest proper or photo shooting. Kagdala naman diri ang layouting process and the submission of the output or the official contest entry. Meaning to say, there will still be a layouting activity after shortly of your photo shooting. After time limit given, the system automatically closes. Next, along with the submission of your contest entry are your 3 authentication photos and 1 10-second video clip while on the layouting process. This shall serve as basis for output authenticity and consistency. So number 1. Sa photo number 1 sa photojournalism nga isubmit sa aton, photo number 1 shall be close-up shot showing the contestant facing the camera while holding the point and shoot digital camera. So mapapicture ikaw, kung if you are a photojournalism contestant, mapapicture ikaw hawid ang imong nga digital camera nga point and shoot. Photo number 2. Photo number 2 shall be close-up shot of the digital camera showing megapixels not exceeding 20.1 and with undetachable lens. So ang sa picture, ang sa photo number 2, close up lang gid siya ang imong digicam nga ginagamit for photos. Dapat makit-an diri kung pila ka megapixel ang ara sa imong camera. So dapat hindi maglapaw 20.1 ang imong camera and with undetachable lens. So kung pwede maukla-ukla ang lens, that could be a ground for disqualification. So be mindful everything naton nga mga guidelines, instructions, the mechanics for judging, no, ara gid gihapon guided by our 2019 to 2020 National Schools Press Conference. Next, ang photo number 3 shall be close-up shot showing the contestant beside the laptop or PC screen presenting the finished entry. So mapalapit lang kasi mo nga laptop or sa PC nga ara gapakita ang imo nga layouting. And one video file containing a 10-second close-up video clip while taking the first official photo entry. Ang imo nga video file dapat makita dira ang imo nga pagkuha sang first picture entry nimo. That will serve as the control shot. Okay? That will serve as the control shot. Next, official contest entry for judging shall be using Microsoft PowerPoint for layouting done in one or single slide. So, ma-layout ka mo sang inyong photos in Microsoft PowerPoint. And then, after layouting is done, the document shall be saved as PDF file. So, isave mo dayon sa PDF file. And then, only the PDF file of the document shall be accepted upon the submission of outputs. Next, all photos must contain time and date stamps. So, dapat sa kada photo, may ara dila date, tag oras, kung saan o ginkuha ang photo. Okay? And lastly, application of filter, editing, and or enhancement programs is strictly not allowed. So, bawal kita mag-edit, ka mag-apply filter. Contest topic shall be given upon registration. Some can be seen in the uppermost part of the official DSPC test paper or instruction, while others perhaps in separate sheets. Next, and lastly, the editorial cartooning or pagguhit ng kartong pang editorial. You have to prepare for any editorial cartooning techniques from data to be provided by the examiner. Next, official downloadable DSPC editorial cartooning or test paper shall be provided where the contestant can only draw his or her editorial cartoon. So, kung sa inyo nga pag-download dira sa link for registration, attached is also the official editorial cartooning test paper on which may ara dira lang gid sang portion sang paper nga dira ikaw maubra sang imo editorial cartoon. Next, there shall be two links to be generated the same man sang sa iban. 2 hours man ang gina-allot for editorial cartooning. And then, along with the submission of your contest entry are your 3 authentication photos and 1 10-second video clip while on the layouting, on your cartooning process. So, photo number 1, close-up shot showing the contestant facing the camera while holding the official DSPC editorial cartooning test paper. Photo number 2, close-up shot while nag-aubra ang bata sang iya editorial cartoon. Photo number 3, close-up shot nga nagapakita nga ang bata holding the finished entry. And then one video file samtang ara siya sa iya nga pag-ubra in the middle of his or her editorial cartoon. Now, the contestant shall only use Mongo Pencil number 2. No other sketching tool shall be used beside the aforementioned. So once done, ipasaya lang man ina dayon online and muna. And finally, you have to secure a spot which has strong internet connectivity or Wi-Fi access for contest purposes. And following instructions is part of the contest. Now, very essential gid ang inyo nga pagpamati kag pag-learn sa aton nga mga experts, sang amon nga mga fellow school paper advisors nga ari diri with us this morning. So the whole morning shall be everything that would serve as our powerhouse nga pwede naton ma bag for the upcoming Division Schools Press Conference, the first virtual DSPC ever in the history of the Schools Division of Roja City or the world, or the universe rather. So much for that. Let's just be time flexible. You can eat your snacks while listening, or later you can take your lunch while doing your outputs. So much for that. Thank you for your time and mabuhay. Waswas Rojas.
Thank you so much, Sir Mark. The heat is still on in campus journalism. So me, myself, also is very excited this coming March for the first ever virtual Division Schools Press Conference. So I know you're all excited. So let's start now our webinar on the first topic on the writing of news. Okay, so I think our speaker is ready and set. All right, so our first topic for this morning is news writing. This will be discussed by the President of the Division Association of School Paper Advisors in Filipino, Ma'am Lourdes Orola.
Okay, magandang umaga. Good morning, kids. Our first topic for this morning is about news writing o pagsulat ng balita. Okay. So, to start with, we will know what is a news. Okay? A news is a timely story information of a latest event which appears to be significantly interesting and unusual to the community. So, please take note of the words timely, latest, significant, interesting, and unusual. Okay. Lagi nating tandaan na sa pagbabalita, kailangan yung news natin, yung balita natin ay timely, kagaganap lamang. Kasi pag ito ay nangyari ng 2 years ago, 1 month ago, we cannot consider it as a news. Kumbaga, panis na yon, di ba? So, aside from being timely and latest, a news must be significantly interesting and unusual. Dapat kakaiba para makuha natin yung interest ng mga mababasa. Okay. Now, our news have its characteristics. So, what are the characteristics of a news? First, it must be accurate. Okay? Accuracy refers to the correctness of statement, names, figures, and other information. It means that you have to give exact figure. Halimbawa, pag nag-uulat ka ng tungkol sa baha, so hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na ang baha ay lampas tuhod. Okay? Kasi halimbawa, kung ang nag-uulat ay unano, pwede nga sabihin na lampas tuhod yung baha. Pero, hindi yun accurate kasi kung ikaw 6-footer, 7-footer, hindi na yun lampas tuhod, di ba? So, kailangan exact. So, pwede mong sabihin umabot ng 1 metro yung baha. Okay? Para malaman ko ano talaga yung exact na figure. Okay? And then, pagdating naman sa pangalan, kailangan alamin mo talaga yung mga pangalan, yung exact, pati yung correct spelling. Okay? And, aside from that, mga pangalan ng place, pangalan ng tao, and everything. Second, okay, characteristic of news is it's being objective. The news does not take any side, showing unfairness. Kaya nga nang sinabi nila, no? Walang kinikilingan, walang pinoprotektahan, serbisyong totoo lamang. Okay? At dahil hindi natutulog ang balita, nakatuto kami 24 oras. Okay? Next, it must be factual. Okay? It consists of actual persons and events which nothing invented. Okay. Pag nagsusulat tayo ng balita, hindi kailangang mag-imbento. Kailangang kunin talaga yung katotohanan. Aside from that, it must be balanced. It means it gives proper emphasis on each fact in relation to other facts. Gives attention to both sides in an issue. Okay? Next, a news must be concise. It is short enough to contain the most important facts. When we write a news, it doesn't need to be very long. Okay? It must be short. Kasi walang sinong mang mambabasa na gustong magbasa ng balita na napakahaba. Pag nakita mo yung balita na isang pahina talaga ng pahayagan yung inuukupa, parang ayaw mo lang simulang basahin, no? And lastly, it must be timely. It refers to the freshness and of immediacy of the event. Kailangan bagong-bago. Now, we have two kinds of news. Okay, the first one is what we call the straight news. Okay, straight news consists of facts reported without elaboration. Straight nga siya, walang, kumbaga, kung sabi siya, wala palabor-labor. Okay, next, the second one is the news feature. Based on facts and writer may give his impression, may describe and narrative without resorting to biased opinion. Okay. Next, we have the steps in writing the news story. Okay. So what we will do when we want to write a news story? First, we have to list down all the data. So take note, all the data. Kailangan lahat-lahat. Kasi nga, it must be factual. Hindi tayo pwede mag-imbento. So kailangan i-list down lahat ng data. Second, we have to arrange facts in descending order of importance. We have to put the most important facts on the first paragraph of the news, and so on and so forth. Number three, make the lead play up the most interesting and important point. As a news writer, we have to know the angle of your news. Okay, so you have to know what is the most interesting and important points, and that's will be your cue in making your lead. Number four, present the other details of the news in the next paragraph to answer the questions not yet answered. Now, in writing a news, we have to follow basic structure. Okay, we called it as the inverted pyramid. Okay, so the basic structure of our news is the inverted pyramid. That means news stories require that the most important most important information be put in the primary lead of the paragraph. If you, kung makikita nyo, yung pyramid natin nakabaliktad, no? Yung pinakamalaking bahagi ay nasa itaas kasi it contains the primary lead. What is the primary lead? Okay, primary lead usually a short paragraph which answers at least 4 or 5 WH question and 1H at its most effective angle. So titingnan nyo kung ano yung angle na maganda, kung tungkol ba sa tao na ibinabalita mo, tungkol ba sa event, or tungkol ba sa petsa, ano yung pinaka-significant doon, yun ang gagawan mo ng lead. Next, after your primary lead, you have your secondary lead. Your secondary lead contains important information not found in your primary lead. Okay? After your secondary lead, you have to write other important details. These other important details complement the main lead by answering those of the 5 WH and 1H which left unanswered on your secondary lead. And the last one is the less important details. This means other less important data that give flesh to the story. Okay. Now, okay. There are two kinds of lead, okay? So one of the simplest way to construct the lead for a news story is to first ask what the story is really about. Now, when you write a lead, we have two kinds of lead. We have the straight lead and the novelty lead, okay? So we'll take up first the straight lead, okay? The straight lead, number one, is what we call the who lead. It answers who is the story about or who is the principal person or organization. So, example of the who lead. Okay. The Bureau of Immigration will allow more foreigners to enter the Philippines starting Tuesday. Okay, and so on and so forth. Now, please take note that the first data or information mentioned is an organization which is the Bureau of Immigration. So, who? Now, we will proceed to the second one. Okay, second straight lead is what we call the what lead. It answers what has happened or what will happen. Example, okay, more foreigners will be allowed to enter the Philippines starting Tuesday by the Bureau of Immigration following the Interagency Task Force for the Management of Emerging Infectious Disease Resolution 98 that expanded the list of foreign nationals allowed entry in the country. Now, please take note that the first information given was okay, the event. And what is the event? That the more foreigners will be allowed to enter to the Philippines. Okay. Next, we have the when lead. This when lead answers the question, when did or when will the event happen? Okay, sample of our when lead. Starting Tuesday, okay, the Bureau of Immigration will allow more foreigners to enter the Philippines and so on and so forth. Okay? So, the first information given on your when lead is the date, okay? So, starting Tuesday. Tuesday is the when, the answer is the one that answers the question when. Okay. Next, number four. Where lead? Okay, where lead? Answers the question, where did or where will the event happen? Okay. So, example, in the Philippines, the Bureau of Immigration will allow more foreigners to enter the country starting Tuesday. So, the first information mentioned is the place where the event will happen or where did it happen. Next one is the why lead. Why lead answers the question, why did or why will this event happen? Example, citing the Resolution 98 issued by the Interagency Task Force for the Management of Emerging Infectious Disease that expanded the list of foreign nationals allowed entry in the country, the Bureau of Immigration will allow more foreigners to enter the Philippines starting Tuesday. So, the first information mentioned is the explanation why will the event happen or why did the event happen. And the last one is what we call the how lead. Okay. It answers the question how did or how will this event happen. So our example is, by implementing the Resolution 98 issued by the Interagency Task Force for Management of Emerging Infectious Diseases that expanded the list of foreign nationals allowed entry in the country, the Bureau of Immigration will allow more foreigners to enter the Philippines starting Tuesday. So the first information explains how did or how will this event happen. Now, out of these six straight leads, okay, the most used or the lead that is most often used are the what lead, the why lead, and the how lead. Okay, now let's proceed to the to another kind of lead, which we call the novelty lead. Okay. First example of the novelty lead is the astonisher lead. So, sample of astonisher lead. Better attend your class on July 24. Okay. Kasi yung July 24, San Juan yun. Maraming lumiliba ng klase. Okay? Next, other example of novelty lead or another kind of novelty lead is what we call the contrast lead. Example of contrast lead is 20 years ago, he was the school's janitor. Now, he came back to he came back to become the college dean. So kung nakikita nyo, mayroong contrast. Kasi dati, janitor siya, ngayon naging dean na. Okay? Next, novelty lead is what we call the epigram lead. It is a verse or quotation. Example, like father, like son. Okay. Next, number 4. We have the picture lead. Picture lead describe a mental picture of a subject. Example, the new dean, although only in his 30s, is already bald. Okay. The next one is the background lead. Background lead describe the setting. Okay. Example, decorated by colored lights, the main entrance become a grand setting for a barrio fiesta as PUP Manila celebrates chu-chu-chu. Okay. Next, another kind of novelty lead is what we call the punch lead. Punch lead is a short, forceful, and explosive statement. For example, God is dead. Okay. Next, we have the parody lead. A parody lead is a parody of a well-known song or poem. For example, Never Say Never. This must be far away from the mind of a 45-year-old man who killed himself. Okay. Next kind of novelty lead is what we call the quotation lead. Example, working in some of the poorest area of my country, I found that it was lack of child support, not poverty, that killed their dreams. Thus revealed former Miss Universe Catriona Gray to. Okay. Then, the last one, we have the question lead. Question lead, example of this is, who will be the next Capiz governor? The answer will be known on 2022. Okay. So, out of these 9 kinds of novelty lead, the most common or most often used is the quotation lead. Now, let's proceed to the basic structure in writing the news. Okay? Now, we have the LTQTQT news writing method. Okay? LTQTQT news writing method is a basic format that can help shape most news stories. Okay? After writing the lead, develop a second paragraph that contains information in the lead. This paragraph should be relatively short, just 1 or 2 sentences, and should lead into a quotation related to the subject of the lead. So that means, okay, LTQTQT means lead, transition, quotation, transition, quotation, transition, and so on and so forth. So we have discussed now about the lead. So after writing your lead, so as a news writer, you have to determine what kind of lead will you use. Either a why lead, a how lead, a what lead, or a quotation lead. Then after that, you have to develop another paragraph. Okay? That will be your transition. But make sure, okay, that this transition will lead to your next paragraph, which is a quotation. After that, another transition, quotation, transition. Now, quotation can be either a direct or indirect. Okay? So, pwede siyang direct ang sinabi, pwede ring halimbawa sa Filipino, ayon sa or according to. Okay, this is also a quotation, but it is called the indirect quotation. So now we will have an example of a news which use the LTQTQT news writing method. So For example, 94% of health workers and non-medical personnel at the Philippine General Hospital have signed up for vaccination against COVID-19, an official said Friday night. That is your lead. Now, let's go to your transition. PGH spokesman Jonas Del Rosario said, this is higher than the 75% acceptance rate that they got in the initial survey done a month ago among 2,000 PGH workers across the line. So that is your transition. Remember, your transition must lead to your next paragraph. So that is your quotation. So third paragraph is, we are hoping that if we set the example and then hopefully being champions of the vaccines, we'll be able to convince other people so that the confidence will be high, he told the chiefs on Signal TV5's One News. Okay, that is the quotation. Then, another transition. Del Rosario admitted the initial hesitancy is 25% of the PGH personnel was uncertainty over the vaccine brand they would get. Okay. Sa Filipino, okay, example ng balita. Halimbawa ng balita na gumagamit ng LTQTQT news writing method. Okay. Tinutulan ng Catholic Bishop Conference of the Philippines ang panukala sa Kongreso na gawing legal ang mga tinatawag na virtual nuptials o pagpapakasal sa pamamagitan ng internet ngayong magkakahiwalay ang mga magkasintahan dahil sa pandemya. Yun ang iyong lead. Nangangamba ang simbahan na lalong darami ang mga peking kasal dahil sa pagsasamantala na mga manluloko. That is your transition. Next, maglilid yung transition mo sa iyong next na quotation. It's going to pose a lot of risk also. Kapag halimbawa matutuloyan, baka makakuha tayo ng mga kasal na hawsyaw. Lalo na atin dito guguluhin ang sanctity ng pamilya. Ayon kay Father Jerome Siciliano, Executive Director ng CBCP Public Affairs Committee. Okay, so yun yung quotation mo. And then the last one is your transition. Layo ng House Bill number 7042 na Representative Ron Salo na amyendahan ang Family Code para kilalanin na legal o may bisa sa batas ang virtual wedding. Now, sa pagsulat ng balita, okay, sa dalawang halimbawa natin, no, apat na paragraph ang ating ginamit. It can be also more than four. Okay? Basta ini-encourage lang na it must be short but concise. Okay, now, we have some tips, okay, in news writing. Kailangan nyo itong tandaan. Una, all about the abbreviation. Okay, so ano yung dapat natin tandaan? What we should remember about abbreviations. First, do not use abbreviations or acronyms that the reader will not recognize quickly. Okay? So, kailangan yung abbreviations or acronyms na gagamitin natin, alam ng lahat. Everybody knows it. Okay? Number two, abbreviate long months such as January, February, August, September, October, November, and December when part of a date. So, for example, January 14, 2010. Otherwise, spell out months when not part of a date. So, for example, she arrives last October. So, the name of the month October cannot be abbreviated because it is not part of a date. Next, always spell out short months like March, April, May, June, and July. Lastly, about abbreviation, use periods in the abbreviations for US or United States and UN, but do not for most others such as FBI, CIA, ABS-CBN, or GMA. When in doubt, spell them out. Next, tips naman ito for the capitalization. Okay. First, Do not capitalize a word unless you have a good reason to do so. What will capitalize are the name of people, like Manny Pacquiao, okay, or the proper names like Shao Man Di Shizu, okay, or the names of the companies like Honda Motors Incorporated, and of course the names of places like Rojas City, and okay, the names of the months like February. Okay, next, tips on the composition titles. Okay, titles of books, movies, operas, plays, poems, songs, albums, speeches, and works of art all follow the same general pattern. Capitalize the principal words and enclose the title in quotation marks. Example, Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. And lastly, capitalize but do not use quotation marks for the Bible and reference works such as almanacs and dictionaries. Okay. Now, we have also our tips in general usage. First, write in the third person. So use he, she, or it. Do not use I, or sa Filipino, ako. No. Avoid the first person, I or me, and the second person, you. Next, omit unnecessary zeros. Like when you write the time 9 p.m., so you write 9 p.m., not 9, okay, colon 00 p.m. And, for example, 7 peso. So do not write peso sign, then 7.00. Okay. Remember, in news writing, we have to, kailangan nating tipirin yung space. No, so hindi kailangan magdagdag ng mga zero kung hindi rin naman mahalaga. Okay? The last one, use the time, date, place pattern to tell when something is happening. So TDP, tandaan 'yan ha. TDP, hindi TGP. Okay, time, date, and place. So the meeting is 12:30 p.m. Monday at CCS Auditorium. So better, the meeting is 12:30 p.m. on Monday at CCS Auditorium. Okay. Next, tips in writing names and titles. Identify people by first name and last name on first reference. Identify them by last name only on later references in the same story. So, pag first time mo i-mention yung name, ibigay mo ang buong pangalan. Halimbawa, Juan de la Cruz. Okay. Sa first paragraph, pag na-mention mo na si Juan de la Cruz, pag i-mention mo ulit yung pangalan niya sa second paragraph, pwede mo nang gamitin yung de la Cruz na lang. Okay? Check a person's title or job carefully. In general, use the title doctor only to refer to medical doctors. If it is important to know that a person has a doctorate in history or doctorate in philosophy, for example, explain that in the next paragraph. Next, capitalize titles if they are used before names. Do not capitalize titles after name. So, example, Barangay Captain Danilo Reyes, or Danilo Reyes, then small letter, Barangay Captain. Okay. Titles of books, articles, songs, television shows, albums, and other composition should be capitalized and put in quotation marks. Do not underline or use italics. Okay. Next. Okay. Tips in body construction of your news. Okay. First, you keep the paragraph short. Those limited to 60 words or less are preferred. Okay. Remember, short paragraphs encourage readers to continue reading. Each paragraph should contain only one idea. Okay. So remember ha, in news writing, we have one sentence, one paragraph rule. Okay. Use simple words. Don't let readers look for dictionary. Do not use high phallotic word. Maglibog pa ang ulo sa imong nagabasa. Okay, next. Make sure information introduced or outlined in the lead is covered in the same order of the body of the story. Okay. And that's all. Thank you for listening on the lecture about news writing or pagsulat ng balita.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Lourdes. So if you have questions to our campus journalists, you can comment your questions in our Facebook Live post. All right. So let's now move on to the second topic, and that is editorial writing. This will be delivered by Ma'am Catherine Pacheca.
Thank you, Sir Jay. How are you, our dear student writers and journalists? So today I am tasked to give you tips and a short review on editorial writing. So good for those who already joined and were trained in journalism, but for our neophytes writers, for our new writers, this will be very helpful for you. So now allow me to share to you some tips on how to craft the editorial article. So editorials are believed to be the heart and soul of the newspapers. So each and every newspaper is incomplete without the editorial section. So here, the writer does not only shares his or her view, but also criticize and appreciate the ongoing topics. Editorial actually is light in nature. They should be interesting, thought-evoking, and debatable at the same time. So let me share to you my slides on editorial writing. O, sa Filipino, tinatawag nating Pangulong Tudling. So, according to Joseph Pulitzer, editorial is the expression of the people's conscience, cause, and convictions. According to William Allen White, bitterness, bias, and fear have no place in an editorial. They make for weakness no matter how much they bluster. And according to M. Lyle Spencer, it is a presentation of facts and opinion in a concise, logical manner or of interesting, significant news in such a way that its importance to the average reader will be clear. So, when we say editorial, it is an article that states the newspaper's stance on a particular issue. Basically, it is a persuasive essay that offers a solution to a problem. Now, let me show you the characteristics of a good editorial. So, according to Reddick, it should have interest, brevity, and force. According to Spears and Loshi, it must have clearness of style, has moral purpose, has sound reasoning, and has the power to influence public opinion. So, my dear student writers, once you are writing an editorial, you really have that power not to influence people, to influence your readers. So, If you can be able to write a very good editorial, you can be able to influence others, influence their belief, influence their somehow their attitude or their views in their lives. So, I have here now the different types of editorial. So, we have different kinds of editorial that you may use It depends on your need or on your purpose. So remember, before you write, of course, you have your purpose. So it depends on your purpose, on what kind of editorial are you going to make use of. So first is the editorial of information. So this one seeks to give information and facts unknown to the reader. Then we have the editorial of interpretation. It explains the significance or meaning of news event, current idea, condition, or situation, theory, or hypothesis. Then we have editorial of criticism. It points out the good or bad features of a problem or situation mentioned in the news. Next, we have the editorial of commendation, appreciation, or tribute. So it praises, commends, or pays tribute to a person or organization that has performed some worthwhile projects or deeds or accomplishments. Then we have the editorial of argumentation. So it argues in order to convince or persuade the reader to accept his stand on the issue. And we also have the editorial of entertainment. So it evokes a smile, a chuckle, laughter while suggesting truth. So medyo light siya because it aims to entertain, but still it would like to state or it would like to emphasize something that is true. Then we have the mood editorial. It presents a philosophy rather than an argument or an explanation. And lastly, we have the editorial on special occasion. So this one explains the significance of a special day or occasion. So what are the functions of editorial? So editorials are written to criticize or attack, to defend, endorse, compliment, instigate, advocate or appeal, entertain, and predict. So sa Filipino, ang Pangulong Tudling ay isinusulat upang magbigay ng magbigay ng kritisismo, klarifikasyon, rekomendasyon, analysis, pagtutok sa kahalagahan o pagpuri, panlibang, at interpretasyon. Interpretasyon. Wrong spelling. Pasensya na. Okay. So, ano-ano ang mga bahagi ng ating editorial? So, what are the parts of our editorial? So, this is the basic parts of our editorial. We have the introduction, beginning, or panimula sa Filipino. The body or the discussion, ito yung katawan. Conclusion and or ang lagom. So ito lang yung pinaka-basic na mga bahagi. But later on, we will discuss each and every part. So every detail of the parts of the editorial. So as of this time, let me give you the do's and don'ts in writing an editorial. Ano ba yung pwede? Ano bang hindi pwedeng gawin habang ikaw ay nagsusulat ng iyong Pangulong Tudling? So, first one, win the reader's interest with a lead paragraph that will encourage him to read further. So, the lead paragraph, or we also call the news peg, plays a very vital role in our editorial article. So, if the lead paragraph cannot arouse the interest of the reader, then the reader for sure will not continue reading your article. So, dapat no interesting yung lead paragraph natin. Then, number two, do not generalize. Use plenty of facts and tell what these facts mean. So, factual information are the basic factors in journalistic writing. So, with our editorial, always search for facts and use them instead of telling general ideas. So, dapat palaging may kasamang factual information yung ating mga sinasabi o yung mga bahaging sinasabi natin. So, hindi lamang opinion ang inilalagay natin sa ating Pangulong Tudling, kailangang meron talaga itong factual information na kailangan mong pagbabasehan. Okay, number 3, we have to keep our editorial short. So, di ba? Dahil kung masyadong mahaba, of course, hindi na babasahin yun lahat ng iyong mambabasa. They will find it boring if it is too long. Okay, number 4, do not preach, scold, or moralize. So, hindi tayo preacher na magbi-preach tayo o magbibigay tayo ng mga, magmo-moralize tayo sa ating ginagawa. So, hindi yun pwede. Then, number 5, relate editorials directly to the lives of the readers. So, if our readers can be able to relate what they are reading, they will be eager to read more and connect with what you are reading. Syempre, yung mga mambabasa natin, mas gaganahan silang magbasa kapag nakaka-relate sila sa ating mga isinusulat. So, kung editorial writers tayo, di ba mas maganda yung kapag isinusulat natin ay yung mga issue na makaka-relate kung sino man yung target audience natin. Okay, then, number 6, you have to avoid the first person I. You have to use the pronoun we. That's what we do in the editorial. 7, you have to write simply. Our target for our are our average reader. So, average reader lang yung target natin. So, make sure that your readers can be able to understand what you are writing. So, you have to avoid highfalutin words and expressions which cannot be understood easily. So, gamitin natin yung mga payak na mga salita. No? Hindi ito pampa-impress ating mga mambabasa. So, yung iba kasi gumagamit ng mga salitang hindi common, no? Yung mga salitang medyo malalalim yung kahulugan. So, let's avoid that because our target here is for our readers to really understand what we are writing. Then, number 8, develop the editorial from only one specific limited idea phrased in one sentence and expanded into the body. Number 9, make your sentences and paragraphs relatively short. So, may mga bahagi tayo na kung maaari ay isa o dalawang pangungusap lamang ang dapat nating gamitin. And number 10, you have to accomplish your purpose. So, before you write, you have your purpose. Then, while writing, you have to accomplish that purpose. Okay, so how do we begin our editorial? So, we have different kinds of editorial beginnings that you can be able to use when you are writing. So, an editorial may start with a simple statement that gives enough of the situation, problem, or news to be discussed. Then, you could also use a question which calls attention to give an idea about the problem or points out the logical development of the topic. And you can also make use of a striking statement which jolts the imagination and arouses the interest of the reader. And lastly, a quotation relevant to the subject under discussion. So, if you would like to use a quotation, you may use, pero wag mo nang gamitin yung mga gasgas na quotation, ha? So, hindi na yun papansinin masyado kasi gasgas na nga. So, maghanap ka ng bagong mga quotation or pwede namang gumawa ng sarili mong quotation which can be relate to the topic or the issue that you would like to convey. Okay, so, here, I have a robotic format of our editorial. Ito yung parang ano lang, parang robot no, na format na pwede nyong gamitin. So, you can be able to use this one if you would like to make your editorial. So, it has different parts. You have the head, the neck, the body, you have the arms and the legs. So at the upper part on the head, it is the intro, which present the problem or situation. So here in your intro, you have here your news peg. So pwede mong gamitin yung news peg dito sa itaas na bahagi. So it is then followed by your stand on the issue. Then in the body, you have to make three reasons or your three positions about your stand on the issue. Then on the outer part of the body, you have the arms. Okay, so in your arms, one should support your arguments with evidences and examples. So, kailangang meron talaga tayong mga ebidensya at mga halimbawa sa mga posisyon na inilalagay natin. So, hindi lang basta posisyon, dapat may evidence at merong examples. So, the other arm are the opposing viewpoints which are rebutted. So, you should shut down the opposition. So, kung ano man yung sinasabi ng opposition, make mention din natin yun, pero you have to make a rebuttal about it. So you have to make a good rebuttal on what the opposition is standing for. Then on the legs, you need to present a logical solution. So if you are complaining of something, that's why meron yung issue, so you must have to give a better way of doing it. So dito tayo gagawa ng ating solution or suggestion. Suggest a solution to the issue or to the problem. And then lastly, you need to recap the stance. So this is just one way of effectively presenting your editorial. So this time, let me really show you a step-by-step way on how you are going to craft your editorial. So let's take up each part one by one. Then later on, I will really give you the example. So, your editorial writing starts with introduction. So, we call it the news peg. So, your news peg answers the questions who, what, where, when. Oh, it does not necessarily be complete, no? Hindi kailangan yung apat nandun talaga. Depende lang kung ano yung kinakailangan or kung ano yung nandoon sa binasa mong news o yung basis ng iyong editorial. So, the news peg is the summary news that gives background information and serves as basis for the readers in understanding the issue being discussed. So, ito yung buod ng balita o yung pinaka mahalagang detalye ng balitang binasa mo na magiging basehan ng iyong editorial. Okay, so let's remember the content of your news peg must be factual. Okay, it is immediately followed by the news peg, which state your stand or reaction on the issue. Ito yung reaction o yung katayuan mo sa issue. So, iba-iba rin ang paraan ng pag-construct mo ng iyong stand or reaction. But still remember, the shorter way that you write it there, the better. Okay? Then we have the discussion part. So, 3 to 4 short paragraphs containing explanations about the issue. So, tatlong maiikling mga paragraph lamang ang gagawin natin sa discussion. So, ito na yung body of our editorial. So, ito na yung katawan ng ating editorial or pangulong tudling. So, here, you will see the reasons about your stand. So, 3 reasons or your positions about the issue. So, dito mo na bibigyan ng mga rason kung bakit iyon ang iyong naging stand sa issue na tinatalakay mo. So, in your discussion writing, you're going to write 3 topic sentences in 3 paragraphs. So, isang topic sentence sa bawat paragraph. So, in each paragraph, you have to explain each topic sentence using the how and why. Then, of course, after your topic sentence, you have to make your support sentences. So, may mga support sentences ka, dito mo na ilalagay yung mga evidences mo at yung mga examples. So, facts plus opinions or vice versa. O, pwede namang magkapalit-palit yan, no? So, meron kang opinion sa bawat paragraph, pero yung opinion mo ay kailangang may katulong siya or may kasama siyang support sentences or evidences. Hindi lang basta-basta ka nagbibigay ng iyong opinion. So, dapat meron kang reason bakit yun ang opinion mo at meron kang basis. So, yun yung sa ating discussion na part or yung body of our editorial. Let's move on to the action part. So, the writer suggests the action expected of the reader, direct or indirect. So, example, we join hands in solving the drug abuse problem of the community by information dissemination and advocacy. So, nakita natin dyan yung highlighted words or phrase, which is join hands. So, dito, ito yung bahagi na magbibigay ng paraan o mga paraan upang masolusyonan yung problema or yung issue na tinatalakay. So, hindi lang ito basta paraan, kundi mas magandang paraan or better ways that you can suggest to answer the issue. So, yung join hands dyan, parang ito yung pinaka main point ng action, no, na gusto mong isuggest na gawin ng iyong mga mambabasa. Okay? Sunod. Ito na tayo sa last part, the conclusion. It can compose of two parts, the reiteration of an important message. So, babalikan mo dito yung pinakaminsahe ng iyong editorial. So, maaaring isang pangungusap ay sapat na. At yung pang last part ay ang challenge. So, ang challenge naman ay maaari ring tinatawag natin punchline na kung saan ay kailangang mag-iiwan ng tanong o hamon sa iyong mga mambabasa. So, dapat striking din yung ating conclusion so that our readers will be challenged or will be moved to do something, no, on the situation that you are trying to convey. So, in our contest, you will be given a fact sheet or pwede rin yung topic, no, na ibibigay sa inyo. So, here, to give you the example, let me give you the situation. No? This will be the situation where our editorial is based. So, here, I'm going to read to you our situation. So, expect rainy days ahead as the dry season has officially ended. The Philippine Atmospheric Geophysical and Astronomical Services Administration, or PAGASA, declared the start of the rainy season on Friday, June 4. The Weather Bureau also forecasts more than 10 tropical cyclones to visit the Philippines this rainy season, including 1 to 2 this June. PAGASA also advises the public to prepare for expected flood and landslides due to heavy rains and incoming possible typhoons. So, ito yung pagbabasihan natin ng ating editorial. Now, so, to craft now our editorial, this is our first paragraph, which is our news peg. So, based on what I have read or what we have read a while ago, it says, rainy days start in June. PAGASA has officially announced the end of summer. Rain, typhoons, flood are expected. In worst situations, devastating typhoons, flash flood, erosion, and tsunamis are catastrophes that people have to prepare for. Then in paragraph 2, you have your stand on the issue. Remember Yolanda? So very simple, but it tries to imply that we have to prepare now during based on the news peg that we have. So note that these are facts answering the what, who, where, and when. Then let's move on to our discussion or the body part of our editorial. So as I told you a while ago, we have three paragraphs in our discussion. So here in our first paragraph, the paragraph is composed of our topic sentence. So you can see there the one written in bold, is the topic sentence, then followed by the support sentences. So the first topic sentence, ito yung ang kanyang unang reason or position about the stand on the issue. So early preparation is a must. It has been beneficial. So ito yung topic sentence niya or yung opinion niya, unang position na opinion niya sa issue. Then it is supported by the sentences, local and national governments are required to have ready and dynamic disaster programs. International organizations advocate disaster preparedness to all people because with climate change, natural disasters have worsened and they occur fast and ruin lives. So that is our first position on the issue. Then the next one, our second paragraph. So again, at the top we have the topic sentence, but of course pwede rin siyang sa ibaba, no? It could be pwede siyang magbaliktad. So we the people need to be prepared in our own homes. So it's the opinion of the writer, it's the second position of the writer. Then with that position, it is again supported by evidences and example, which is with life's busy schedules, we tend to be lax during sunny days, but in these days natural calamities are likely to occur. We must be ready 24/7. And the third position or the third paragraph in our discussion or body, okay, so still at the top, you can see the topic sentence. The schools teach pupils how to prepare for the calamities and disasters. So support sentences, maintaining emergency kits, knowing how to use them, and knowing what to do during emergencies and disasters are very important. Okay, so we are done with our discussion or the body part of the editorial. Let us have now the action part. So here, in our action part, we have, as the saying goes, there is no substitute for preparation. We do prepare. So the phrase there, we do prepare, is very very striking, which will somehow encourage the reader, mag-i-encourage siya sa ating mambabasa na gawin yung sinasuggest mong action. So meron ka diyang sinasuggest, suggestion lang, or somehow ito yung gusto mong gawin ng iyong mga mambabasa. And the last part is the conclusion. So readiness and vigilance prevent or mitigate the harsh effect of disaster, trusting God above all, which entails action. Perfect the preparation. So yung unang sentence doon is the reiteration of the important message. So parang binabalikan mo o binubuod mo yung pinaka-importanting mensahe ng iyong editorial. At yung last part, yung last sentence natin, ito yung challenge o yung hamon sa ating mambabasa, or tinatawag din natin minsan na punchline. Okay, so remember, the challenge or the punchline should leave something for the readers to think about. Okay, meron talaga silang pag-iisipan. Parang macha-challenge sila kung gagawin ko ba or hindi. So this is the full editorial writing example. So ito na yung buong bahagi na makikita mo. So ganyan lang kasimple, no? Ganyan lang kaikli ang ating editorial. So para sa ating workshop na gagawin, so, ito lang yun, ha. Balihin natin ko na for the secondary and for the elementary. So, you can have a screenshot. So, later, the link where you can send your output will be sent to you, later. So, ano na yun, lahat na yun ng ipapasa ninyo. So, magbibigay ng mga links. So, for secondary, for English, actually, pareho lang, no? Tinanslate ko lang sa Filipino. You have to write an editorial article about your stand on the approval of nationwide COVID-19 vaccination in the Philippines. Or gumawa ng editorial tungkol sa iyong paninindigan tungkol sa pag-aproba ng pangmalawakang pagbabakuna laban sa COVID-19 sa Pilipinas. So, you just choose. If you are in editorial writing English, so you write in English. For Filipino, you write in Filipino. And for the elementary, you have to write an editorial article about the effect of online class to the study of pupils like you, or gumawa ng editorial tungkol sa epekto ng online class sa pag-aaral ng mga kabataang tulad mo. Okay? So, kayo nang bahalang maghanap ng inyong mga pwedeng pagbabasihan na sources para sa inyong editorial. So, I hope you learned something, my dear student and pupil writers, young journalists. So, thank you very much for listening. And may I turn you back to Sir Jay.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Kath, for the comprehensive discussion of the editorial writing. So at this juncture, let's move on to the topic 3 of this activity, and that is the feature writing. This will be delivered by Ma'am Teresa Milliares.
Good morning, mayong aga, magandang umaga. Welcome to the Writing Effective Feature Articles o Pagsulat ng Lathalain topic. So today, this very moment, unfreeze your minds. Now, you just heard those two topics. Medyo seryo siya. Ang writing news, the news writing, and also the other one, the editorial writing. So, pag sinabi natin feature writing, it is lighter this time o ang pagsulat ng lathalain. So children, high school and elementary learners, congratulations na kayo ang napili ni Ma'am at ni Sir na sumali sa ganitong contest. Ibig sabihin, kayo ay talagang readers, magaling magbasa, rich in vocabulary, and you really do love writing. Kasi ito naman talaga ang kailangan kapag ikaw ay isang feature writer. Bakit? So, what is a feature? A feature article is a good story told well in print. So, sabi nga, pag magaling kang magkwento, magaling kang feature writer. As one editor said, a news story is like a textbook. Gusto niyong magbasa ng textbook. And a feature story is like a novel. So, ganun yon. To be well-rounded, you read both. You turn to the textbook for information and knowledge. You pick up the novel for entertainment, escape, and enjoyment. It instructs, informs, and advises, but its main objective is to entertain. So, wag mawala sa reason why you are writing because you are a journalist. Still, you have to inform. Now, feature writing, as I said, hindi tayo mawawala sa facts. Andun pa rin yung katotohanan dapat sa sinusulat natin. Hence, it is not the same as novels and short stories. Aba, ma'am, kanina sabi mo, yung feature writing, ano yun? Parang novel siya. Pero bakit hindi ako makaka-imagine na lang? As I said, we are journalists. Although we are trying to entertain people, still facts should be there. So, because of that, we have to know the qualities of a good feature article. It deals with any topic. Yes, you heard it right. Any topic under the sun, or even the sun itself, they say. It usually entertains more often, and it informs, instructs, or advises. It may be long or short, as long as it covers the subject adequately and keeps interesting to the readers. If you observe, marami tayong nababasa na maikli lang, meron namang mahahaba. Pero, see to it, anuman yan kahaba, the interest of your readers will still be there. It may be light or serious depending on its purpose. It could be formal or informal and written in any form and in style but well organized. Diba mga especially elementary, yung gusto nyong ipaabot, minsan nawawala ka, then you really have to go back. Ano ba talagang gusto mong ipaabot? It should be organized. It may or may not be timely. If story should be, news ay dapat timely siya, dito naman sa feature writing, kahit yung nangyari pa sa panahon ng lolo mo, ay pwede mo siyang maisulat, ma-featureize mo siya. it begins with a novelty lead. So dapat you will really have to attract, you have to attract your readers. It is written in ascending interest. Hindi na very excited kang nagsimula, then bigla na lang, wala ng energy. It is based on facts. Though sometimes the writer uses his imagination to play up the details, it is still anchored on facts. So facts pa rin, andun siya. It can be garnished with adjectives. Sino ang kumakain ng salad, di ba? Ito, pwede kang kumain ng salad na walang garnishing, walang design. Pero pag may garnishing, may colorful veggies, ma-add up yung interest mo na kumain nun. So, ganun siya sa feature. Figures of speech should be rich. The dialogue, the anecdote, local color, and idiomatic expressions. So, yung mga nakakatawa na mga kwentong narinig mo, maikli lang siya, pero nakakatawa, pwede mo siyang ilagay sa feature. It can be written in the first, second, or third person. So, ganun yun. So, review natin ha sa mga elementary. First, of course, yung sarili mo, magagamit mo talaga yun sa feature writing. Yung second, parang may kausap ka. And yung third, may pinag-uusapan ka. Ganun. So, next. So, ma'am, ano ba pwedeng i-topic? So, sabihin ko sa inyo, maraming pwedeng maging topics when it comes to feature. So, we can have the profiles, the character sketches, yung mga kilala, experiences, inspiring narratives, the travelogue, saan ka pumunta, saan magandang puntahan, yon. Social concerns or phenomena, the how-tos, paano gawin to, paano lutuin yan, yon. Trends in different fields, food, fashion, and technology. Also, we can have competition. So, sports ba ma'am pwede? Of course, competition. At kung ano-ano pa mga contest sa schools, di ba? And next, we can also have the conflict. Conflict is talagang andyan yan. No? Sa magkakapatid, sino ang mas mahal ni mama, ni papa? Conflict yun. Whether between or among individuals, groups, associations, kahit saan, may kompleto. To controversy, ano daw, mga magpapakasal na si ano, so that's controversy. Whenever people disagree or argue, if that debate has at least a potential impact on others, those others suddenly become interested, and that's a good topic for a feature. For the consequence, if readers consider the story important, they'll give it their time. Ito, importante to. Babasahin ko to. So, ano bang importante sa panahon ngayon? I will write about it. Family and community, home and school, food and shelter, jobs and leisure, healthy and looks, ethnicity and electricity, weather and water are of consequence. Lahat ng mga bagay na to, you can write about these things. Also, familiar or famous persons. Sino ba ang mga famous persons sa school, sa community? You can write about them. Also, fear. Ma'am, di ba sabi, dapat mag-entertain. We have to entertain, but bakit fear? Yes, when we write feature, we can really also write about fear. It's negative, granted, and many folks aren't drawn to negatives, but those shadows and forces, visible and invisible, that threaten or harm us, definitely attract our attention. May mga pupas nga kami, pag napunta kami ng mga bookstores, walang bibilhin kundi yung nakakatakot, tapos yun, nginginig-nginig, kasi natatakot. Pero ba't nagbasa? Because it is interesting. And so, we can also use that in feature writing. Wow, heart-stirring. The race against death from a killer disease, a homeless child, finding love and family, a jobless and aging couple receiving comfort or help. These may not be important stories, but they're magnets for most readers, no? So yung mga paubaya ng mga sitwasyon, yun ay mga heart-stirring. So pwede talaga siya isulat bilang feature. Okay, humor. No, humor, nakakatawa siya. So, if the situation calls for it, and writer, editors know how to handle it, why not? usually yung mga writers, medyo serious daw sila. Pero there are those who are really talented and very humorous. Dito natin magagamit yung mga anecdotes. Just like the other day, yung contestant naming isa sa school, kilala ko rin siya kasi pamangkin ko. Sabi ko sa kanya, "Oh, ano gusto mo sa photo journal? Sa Filipino ka ba or sa English?" Sabi niya, "Math. I want math." No? So sumasali pala siya sa journal, hindi niya alam na wala dun math writing ito. So it's something, it made me smile. At kung susulat ako, I could use that na beginning ng aking isusulat. It could be an anecdote of someone joining a contest na hindi niya talaga alam kung anong pinapasukan niya. Humor makes people laugh or chuckle, and that's good. If you could make people laugh of what you are writing, then you are one very effective feature writer. Problem. Discover something that your readership deems a problem, and you've got yourself a built-in audience for the article, and you converse about it. Although it's a problem, it will really entertain. Next, progress. Yes, we want progress. We're thrilled by it, or at least encouraged. Now, it gives hope to us. Progress against the seas and raging elements, against unemployment and illiteracy, against discomfort and hatred makes us feel better. We like to read about what makes us feel better. Diba nang sinabi, hindi na tayo pupunta ng school, ano kaya ang mangyayari? Hindi na ba kami papasa? We will just be staying in our own grade level. Then we realize people in the DepEd are doing their best na mag-progress pa rin tayo. We will move on, and it's something we can write about. Next, the solution or success. If there are problems, there are solutions. The victory, the triumph over odds, the race won, the mess cleaned, the confusion cleared. Editors should seek to chronicle such encouraging events. And that's a good topic too. The unknown. Yes, mga bata, teenagers, you are so interested with this. Ano kaya meron sa end ng rainbow? No, sa panahon ninyo ngayon, alam nyo na na nothing is there at the end of the rainbow, pero sa panahon namin noon, natatakot talaga kami. What's in the end ng rainbow na yan? At the end of the rainbow, ano kaya meron? It's so unknown for us. The mysteries of a vast universe and mini micro subatomic things intrigue us. Ano meron sa kabilang planeta? Ano meron sa kaldero ni Lola na ayaw niyang buksan? From ocean deep to heaven, we're inquisitive about what we do not know, and it's a good thing. About angels, about heaven, about hell. Next, the unusual. What? Ano? Ba't nangyari yon? The old man bites dog, di ba? Sa news writing, yun, we call it news kung kakaiba siya. Also, in feature writing, the old man bites dog principles that journalists have traditionally followed still works. A cheating business magnate is sentenced to endow a chair in ethics. Ano? Cheater siya? Pero ano siya? Naging manager siya? Sa isang university? Naging president siya? That is so unusual. I will write about it. A girl writes the president of Russia about peace and love, and it is invited to see him. It is unusual. Of course, these things interest us. The eccentricities, the departures from the norm, make pleasurable or adventurous reading. Yung kakaiba talaga, hindi pa siya nangyari. Yung kagabi, yung binalita na ilang kilometro yun, nagbike lang ang tao para ihatid yung package, kakaiba yun. Kaya finiture nila. The wants and needs. Anything your readers believe they want or actually do want or need, they'll read about it. You can count on it. No, yung mga pangangailangan. Ano bang pangangailangan ng tao? Kasi pag kailangan mo, it interests you. So why not write about it? Okay? Next. Now, okay ma'am, maganda pala magsulat ng feature. So ano ba yung techniques? Kasi ma'am, baguhan lang ako. So children, kids, ito yon. The 5 techniques. Adding specific information, choosing words carefully, creating sensory images, using figurative language, and writing dialogue. Iisa-isahin natin. Paano ba ito gamitin? Specific information, identifying specific activities and behaviors. Describe the actions that the characters are doing as concrete and as specific as possible. Eto ha, we have here two kinds of sentences. Ang isa, we use this kung normal lang, wala kang intention na mag-entertain. Ganito lang, isusulat mo lang siya ng ganito. And it is poor when you are a feature writer. The man left the bag in the street. Yun lang, di ba? Boring. Pero, when you featureize it, you do it this way. The man turned to the left towards Elm Street. There, he dropped the package that conceals the mysterious object that the cops were chasing after. Now, it's interesting. Next, specific information, naming and describing characters. Describe the characters by telling us about their physical appearance and personality. So, you have to picture out really the characters. How will you do it? Ito ha, the good thing na magagawa natin when we are using the feature, only a happy-go-lucky teenager like Justine can afford to cram his work like that. Tall, handsome, and athletic. He loves it more to be in the field than in the classroom. So, nakita mo si Justine kung gaano talaga siya ka-lazy. Pero pag sinulat mo lang siya, simply, Justine is very lazy in school. Pero sa feature, pinahaba mo siya so that readers will be able to picture it out. Specific information, identifying and describing settings. Describe the setting down to its specific location, the time, and even weather. Example, eto ha, ano siya? Kung boring lang or simple lang, gumagawa ka lang talaga ng sentence, New York City was a scary place to go to after the terror attack. Okay, yun lang. Pero pag good siya, covered with a huge cloud of debris, ash and smoke. Ito, may mga aso-aso na. New York City became a ghost town after the Twin Towers fell last September 11. Now you can feel na ano siya, sad na siya. Nakakatakot. Ano na talaga yung atmosphere in that place? Next, specific information listing attributes. The characteristics include other details and observations that will make your description more interesting. This is how you do it. Pag ito lang, simple lang siya, it's poor. The boy walked along the beach. Diba? So, sinong boy? Maybe I will imagine about the boy na naka-shorts, yung iba matangkad, yung iba mataba ang ini-imagine. Masaya siguro siya, pero when you featureize, you do it this way. Wanting only to be with the hymns of the seagulls and the melody of the crashing waves. O, diba? Nakita mo na the waves were crashing. The boy went out of the noisy hotel and took a walk along the beach as the sun colors the sky with deep red. Pwede mo nang mapinta. So, that's how we do the feature writing. And next, creating sensory images. Now, we talk about senses this time. Good descriptive essays appeal to the reader's five basic senses. Okay? Kids, ano five senses natin? Okay? So, we have here the sensory images. These are words that create a mental picture of the topic. Subject, one is describing in such a way that the words or phrases used appeal to our five basic senses. Yung ating mata, yung ating mamaya, iisa-isahin natin. Yes, the sense of sight first. The glittering sparkles of gold. The bluish haze of the sky. So, for example, nagsusulat ka. Sasabihin mo lang, masaya sa bahay, di ba? Pero pag gusto mo talaga makita nila, marinig nila, you can say, tawanan, kulitan, biruan, ang laging naririnig sa aming tahanan. So, sasabihin ng nagbabasa, ay, ang saya nga nila, no? So, next, the sense of smell. Pwede bang ma-smell ang binabasa? Yes. The invigorating aroma of coffee. The putrid and damp scent of the canal. Pao, nako, parang naaamoy mo siya. So, halimbawa, sa Filipino, binigyan ako ng mabangong bulaklak. Yun, simple lang yun, di ba? Hindi siya featureized. Pero, if feature mo siya, nagising ang natutulog kong damdamin dahil sa napakahalimuyak ng mga rosas na napakasariwa. So, yun, parang ano talaga, you can picture them out after that. Also, the hearing, the clattering of coins, the thud of a basketball, parang naririnig mo siya, humahangos, tumitibok-tibok na puso. Okay, naririnig mo na ngayon. Then, the sense of taste, the sweetness of chocolates, the savory flavor of beef curry. So, pag sinabi mo naman, nakakatakam, nakakalaway na luto ni nanay, parang, hay nako, tanghali na, kakain na ako dahil sa nabasa ko. And also, the sense of touch. Yes, kahit that sense, dapat talaga may feel sa pagsulat. The humid atmosphere in the tropics, the rough edges of a rock. Halimbawa, nagsulat ka tungkol sa pusa mo, nanginginig sa lamig si Kuting na makita ko siyang pinagsiksikan ng kanyang manipis na katawan sa makapal at magaspang na pader na napipicture out talaga siya. Okay? So, that's for the senses. Now, gusto talaga ng Roja City Division na magaling kayo. Kaya, these are the tips for good feature writing pa. Make the lead inviting, clear, and simple. So, simple lang, pero clear. Use quotes when they speak louder than a paraphrase, no? Use examples, anecdotes, as I said earlier, parang review na lang ito, and details when they help make the point of the piece. Give the story movement by blending paragraphs with transitions, by using short words, and by varying sentence rhythm. Pwede yon. Good writing is built on a foundation of solid reporting. Go to the scene. Talk to the source personally. For example, nag-feature ka talaga ng isang tao, go interview para maano mo, makuha talaga yung gusto mong ipaabot ng gusto ng iyong feature. Also, we need now. We have to do the wordcraft. Paano siya? Parang ano pa rin siya, related sa kanina natin pinag-usapan. Be specific and bring people in. Make your readers involved. Halimbawa, ito ha, not specific, more examples for you. She appreciated the beauty of the Sampaguita in her mother's garden. Pero pag specific na, ganito na siya. Luis's heart warmed upon seeing the Sampaguita's long stems coiling around the trellis while flowers perfuming the late afternoon air in the mother's garden, in her mother's garden. So, you try. Make the sentence specific and bring in a person. Try it now. He owned a brand new car that impressed everyone. Okay, you can have the screenshot then. Try it later. Next. Animate, the inanimate, yung walang buhay, bigyang buhay, no? Leaves are on the floor, ganun lang, yung daw, nandun lang sa floor. Pero, pag animate na siya, leaves lie on the cold floor, as if tao siya. Na yun, nakalay siya sa floor. Inanimate, the hills had no vegetation of the mine's sulfurous fumes. Pag animate na, the hills are strapped of their vegetation and the mine's sulfurous fumes choke new growth. Animate, yun siya, the animating the inanimate. Now, let's go to show, don't tell. Ito lang, pag nagtitell ka lang, and it is not effective in feature writing. Johnny was happy when he received his package. Pero sa show, John ate excitedly opened the package from his sponsor. His eyes lit up and a broad smile appeared on his face. I love the toys. Yung sinabi ni John, sinabi talaga, they're beautiful, he said with a giggle. Eto, when you just tell, Jose Roman worked hard. Pag show mo sa feature na, before the sun could rise, Jose Roman would wake up and prepare the fishing nets. He pushed his banca to the shore and paddled by his lonesome until he was in an area where fishes abound. From there, his work day begins. Ganon siya ka nag-work hard. Now, you are showing. Another activity for you to practice. A man who proposes his love to a woman. Ito ang next example niyan. Paano? Papakita. It was like Pepe's Sunday was a rain of kisses when his heart is pounding with all I love yous towards Trisha. All the butterflies played rock and roll in his stomach as his sweat went rolling down like excited warriors for a battle. But Pepe was in a different battle and it was to win Trisha's coveted yes that would mean a heaven to Pepe. Like a mighty wave of the vast ocean, his heart, fully tanked with love, has just exploded through his lips saying, Trisha, kinahigugma ko ikaw. Diba? High school! And both of the world were enchanted with the magic of love. Kag ang nagbasa, magkilig-kilig na. Okay. Next, structure of the feature story. Descriptive and narrative techniques this time. Okay? A feature story must have a main theme. This is a story writing version of the hard news angle. The main theme is always the spine of the story. Everything else branches from it. Why is the theme useful? It is where you organize your facts, quotes, and anecdotes. As I said, wag mawala. The theme is what your feature is about. Ito ang isa. Feature article style A na gustong-gusto ko rin gamitin. You have the lead, usually anecdote or quote. Example, my favorite quote ka, time is so blah blah. You will have a quote there. Then you go now to your introduction of person or situation being featured. Then the thesis. Then the significance of the topic, further description. And of course the conclusion now. Yung lead mo, kinonclude mo na ngayon, andun na lahat. And then, maganda siya pag yung conclusion mo, minsan ginagamit nila yung ginamit nilang quote sa una, ginamit nila sa conclusion para masettle siya. Then, this style B, point of crisis. There's a problem. May crisis. Then, the flashback. Bakit nangyari ang problem na to? If a flashback mo siya, moment of insight, what have you learned from that situation? Resolution. Ano ngayon ang solusyon mo? Pwedeng mabigay na solusyon. Then, lesson learned. Pwede na masabi mo sa audience mo or sa reader mo ang isusulat mo in that last part. This one, among the journalists, ito laging ginagamit nila, is the Wall Street Journal formula on writing a feature story. Hindi naman nagkakalayo. Of course, you still have the beginning. And the beginning, start with an anecdote again, just like ang kanina, the illustration. And then the theme, shortly after the beginning, state the point of the piece. We have there the body, provide details that elaborate the theme. Tell the reader what is happening and why and what's being done about the situation. And of course, the ending. Mag-end talaga ha, baka mabitin yung readers niya. Okay. Are you ready now for the practice? Of course, push that pen. Thank you for listening. And later, we will give the exercises or the contest piece. Exercise na contest lang na output ninyo for the feature writing. Thank you so much and thank you for watching. God bless.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Milliaris, on the discussion of feature writing. So we are now down to the last topic for this morning, and that is the copy reading and headline writing. So this will be discussed by no other than Mr. Mark Julius Fuentes.
Good morning once again, and for those and for the benefit of everybody who was asking about the matters announced earlier, so the guidelines shall be disclosed to you. They are all be given to you attached through a memorandum or corrigendum of our upcoming DSPC. Do not worry, you shall have a copy of those ASAP.
So tanan ka mo makakopya gids of the guidelines about it. So now let's go back to our job. I will be talking to you about the copy reading and headline writing. Now, una gid nga requirement kung ikaw isa ka copy reader, kinahanglan mayad-mayad ikaw mangita sang sala. Okay? If you are a type of OC kind of person, or lang daw na may antagid siya, pero may daw na binantayan mo na lang niya ang sala ni ma'am ni mo or ni sir ni mo sa iya nga pagklase, ma'am ba ka sir? Do sala ban sir imo nga pagsulat sang there, di ba sir? Una ang E kaysa I. Ang imo bala sir contraction sir, kulang sang apostrophe. Sir lang daw bala sir ang test paper sir, oh, the wrong grammar. No? So kung kami mandayon niya, do nami mandayon kamo pang himuon shake kag imnon. So actually, that is a great character trait of a copy reader. Once know si ikaw, and once isa ikaw kabata nga, doon namian ka lang magpinang check sang spelling or the vocab, or namian ka permi maglantaw sang mga sala sang iban nga tao. Ay, sa ibang nga tao, sa mga outputs gali, sa mga stories, or sa mga test papers, sa mga books and magazines, no? Pwede ikaw sa copy reading and headline writing. But, now, nga man sir, kinahanglan gid namon mag-copy read. Why copy read? Ano ang pulos nga man kinahanglan gid namon mag-copy read? So, tandaan naton, editing a copy is not just a simple task or correcting errors in grammar and facts. Ngaman, unchecked data which often injected in the copy submitted by neophyte writers, if unnoticed, could put both the story and the paper in the bad light. Imagine all our leading newspapers who were being sold by bystanders or all along the stalls sa sidewalks nato, no? Nga ginapangbaligya ng mga newspapers, or perhaps posted in a famous news portal of the locality. So what if kung damo sala ang ina sa nga news portal or ang isa ka publication or ang leading newspaper sa bilog ng Pilipinas? Would you still buy it? Siyempre, hindi. No? Kay wala na kita sang kwarta. No? Kay gin pang lupad na. Okay? So now, hindi na kita magbakal sina kay tungod damo-damo inasa sang mga sala. Okay? So, kung may mga data dira or information nga unchecked, nga kag nakitaanin mo nga mga damo-damo sala, mabalik ina sa credibility sang newspaper or journalism team. So, nga man, mabakal pa kami sa imong newspaper or nga man, mabisit pa kami sa imong news website or page kung amon man lang mabasahan, puro sala. Remember, as campus journalists, our main target and job description is to always serve the people the truth. Okay? Because we belong to the fourth state of our country, and that is journalism. Okay? So kita ang una-una gid nga pamangkutan sang tao in case there are typhoons coming, in case they are about to have, you know, mga unlikely nga mga incidents nga matabo. So kita gid ang una nga pamangkutan. So kung sala ang aton ginasulat dira and damo-damo nga spelling, no, kalain na da. I still remember when I was in college, in a magazine, feature magazine. So, kisa, do nakapoy ka na, magbalik dito sa imo gin-interview, because during that time, nag-interview kami sa mga nagabaligya kandila sa patio. Okay? So, tamaran na kami magbalik pa sa nagabaligya dito sa patio sa mga kandila. Kaya tungod hassle na, mabalik ka na naman liwat. So, ginhaum-haum namon ang spelling sang iya nga name. Only to find out, ginbalikan kami. No, ginpatawagin amon nga attention to think nga ang pangalan nga ginggamit wrong spelling. So, do dako nga slap sa imo kung isa ikaw ka journalist, kag wala mo ma-check even ang pangalan sang tawo nga gina-include nimo. Okay, next. Now, what are your functions as a copy editor? So these are your functions. First, you have to check facts, the name of a person, the name of the place, no? You have to correct errors in grammar, spelling, punctuation, usage, organization, and others. So, dapat ma-master nyo, or if not nga ma-master nyo, gid, ma-familiarize ninyo ang basic subject and verb agreement. No, diba? Do balik-balik yan lang ang ginatudlo sa ito ng mga English teachers. No? Singular subject takes singular verb. Plural subject takes plural verb. No? So, those are the basics of the grammars. The spelling, the punctuations, when can I put apostrophe or dash or hyphen? Okay. Shall I be writing in number or the word of a particular amount? The usage, the organization, and others. So as well, kinanglan mo gid mag-improve sa news value and write effective lead. Now, pamangkot ni Sir Mark, ano sa inyo ang effect, ano sa inyo ang lead? Kung pamakotan ka mube, what is the meaning of a lead? Ang lead, children, amuna siya ang pinaka-importante nga paragraph nga dapat makitaan sa pinakauna nga part sang isa ka news. So kung mag-contest ka mo sa March 2 or 3 or sa March 4 and 5, tandaan. Ang una nyo gid nga pangitaon is kundiin ang lead. No? So, hindi nyo pagkalimtan nga kung mag-contest ka mo, ginanambiran ninyo ang pasunod sang aton nga mga paragraphs. So, once imugid makita ang lead, nambiran mo na nga daan, ini siya ang lead. Butangan mo sa left side sang paragraph nga saan nyo nando mushroom, dahil butangan mo 1. Diin dayon ang next nga importante nga balita. 2, 3, 4, 5, so forth and so on. Not amo ginaimo una nga pangitaon. Nga man sir, dira gid kami sa lead mabase. Kag siya gidamon una nga pangitaon. Kay dira kamo mabase naman sang inyong nga headline writing. Indi na kamo magpangita pa sang iban sang inog title nyo or ulo ng balita or headline other than sa lead. Kay dira lang kidya sa lead naton makita ang headline. Ano na da sir ang makita sa lead daw? Ang sa lead kung ano ang natabo, sino ang mga tao nga involved sa natabo. Okay, sa diin natabo, nga man natabo ang insidente, kag paano natabo ang insidente. Mostly, all the 5 W's and 1 H questions shall be found in the lead. So that's how important the lead is. So gani una mo gid pangitaon ang lead. So pagkatapos na, madiretso ka na dayon sa mga symbols or pagmarkings. So next, you have to delete editorializing materials in a news. So kung sa news, bawal kita maghatag sang aton nga opinion. Makita ka mo da nga, sa aking palagay, hindi na yan pwede. So sa aking pagkanto, ang Pangulo ay nagiging epektibo sa panahon ng pandemya. So that's is an opinion. That is not the truth unless you have basis from it. Would it be taken from an interview or press conference or whatsoever? But if not, then it's an opinion. You have also to guard against libelous statement and you have to write headlines and decide its typography. Now, kung mag-decide kita sang typography, di ba may printer's direction kita dira? Okay, kinanglan mo dira mag-decide kung ano nga font ang imo gamiton. Ano nga size ng font ang imo nga gamiton. So that still includes in the competition in copy reading and headline writing. You have to make your copy simple and clear. Tandaan, once gani mag-erasure ikaw sa imo contest sa March 2 and 3 or 4 and 5, hindi ka naya mag-expect nga madaog ikaw. Gani kung makasala ikaw, imo erison kay magamit man kamo lapis, you have to erase your markings in the most or pinaka ang neatest nyo gid possible way of erasing your errors. okay, nga pinakamalimpyo kag pinakamanami nyo gid nga pagbutang sang symbols. Gamatter gid ang neatness sang imo nga output, sa imo nga pagdaog. So you make copy simple and clear. Next, make copy conform to the newspaper style sheets. So, hindi naman na kinanglan because we are not for a publication. But you have to give instruction to the typesetter regarding font type and font size to be used and the number of columns and M's. So I guess I have told you that already. And ari ang pinaka-importante sa tanan, yung gid nga malagpat, the indication of corrections by using the copy reading marks. So dapat ninyo gid malagpat ang mga copy reading marks nga ginahatag sang inyo nga mga coaches. So next, we have here the copy reading marks, no? May mga boxes dala containing the words or phrases which contain errors. So in the first box, we have their Philippines, which all letters are written in small caps. So we have to capitalize the letter P because Philippines is a proper noun. So kung mag-proper noun kita, it is a specific or particular name of a person and place. And now, since Philippines is a proper noun, the first letter should be capitalized and in big letter. So para naton ma change ang letter P sa big letter, hindi kita yung magbutang sang big letter P si Babo niya or that ulan natin sa big letter P. But we have only to write a symbol or mark. And it is... Okay, maulat kita, mag-enter. And aton ibutang ang... Ma'am Nels. Kinanglan natin magbutang sang tatlo ka line under sina nga letter. So, pero for example, may DOH, diba? Ang DOH, abi, small letters, tanan. So, hindi mo pag-isa-isahon, no? Hindi mo pag-isa-isahon sulat ang mga letra or tatlo ka lines under sa each letter. Pwede mo nga pinsanon na lang tanan-tanan ang pagsulat sang linya up halin sa D hasta sa H. So, pinsan na lang. Next, my brother. Ang brother dila must be written in small letter because it is a common noun. Wala pangalan dila kung sino dila si brother. No? So, wala dila si brother patrosinyo or si brother sinuman dila. Wala sang may ginhambal dila. So, ang brother, i-change mo into small. So, ang small nga letter, ang big letter B, to be changed into small cap, dapat mabutang ikaw sang mark nga slash. No, muna sa children mag-change sang big letter into small letter. Now mag-spell out naman. Ari pagid kung namati ka mo kagaina kay Ma'am Lourdes Orola sa iyang State on the Nation address. I mean sa iyang talk sa news writing, no? Hambal dira basta sa balita gani ang number 1 2 3 4 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 must be written in words. They have to be spelled out in words. Dapat nakasulat sila sa mga letra. Okay? Pagtungtong na niya 10, 11, 12, hasta sa pinakamataas nga number, dapat naka-figure na ina siya. Okay? Nakasulat na siya in numeric form. So, dira ang number 7, kitungod humble ni Sir Mark, ang 7 is under pa lang siya sa 10, butangan mo circle ang para sa makita niya sa screen. No? Kag ang Mr., wala man naging hambal kung ano nanda sinyo na dira nga Mr. Okay? So, pwede nga Mr. Rizal. Ay, wala man. Te, mabutang ka lang or ma-abbreviate ka lang sang M, big letter M with small letter R and period kung may apelyido nga kasunod. But if there's none, imo lang na siya i-spell out nga M-I-S-T-E-R, Mister. So, in-circle mo siya. Next, ang 24, diba? Subla siya 9. So, dapat naka-number na siya. So, mag-change ikaw sa figure, magiging, okay, in-circle mo lang man gyapon. Okay, next. ang Friday. Ang Friday, FRI period siya dapat. No? Period siya dapat. So, i-abbreviate mo siya. Imo mo siya gapon na in-circle. Next, separate words. Mag-separate ikaw dula sang words ng taong tadaong beautiful lady. So, nalimtan, for example, ni Ma'am Nelsa magpindot sang space. Na ano yun si Ma'am Nelsa? Ya, na pinalimtan niya magpindot sang space. Nagsugpon ang beautiful kag ang lady. So, para mag separate ikaw sang word, butangan mo lang mataas nga kurit nan pareho sa dira sang inyo nga nakita. Next, indent as a new paragraph. So life is the best gift from God, wala indention, tandaan ha, all paragraphs must have indention or anang space bala before the first word. So mabutang ka lang sang big letter L nga may do mushroom paragraph symbol. Nan, kita nyo na. Okay, next. Start a new paragraph. So, kung makita nyo dala, exist and die. Life is the best. Okay, kung imo sa i-judge or kung imo siya i-assess, ang next nga sentence is instilling to us a new thought. So, lain naman sila iyang iyayang concept. So, dapat nakaseparate siya into a different paragraph. So, butangan mo lang sang okay, paragraph man nga sign or symbol. Dayon, butangan mo lang siya. Pwede man siya butangan man sang intention nga symbol. Okay, next. Ang changes. So, kung mag-delete ikaw, no, doon lang tawunin mo ang mga changes, dira. May ara nga nagadululubli nga mga letter C. Dayon, may ara nga nagadululubli nga kwarta, letter S. No? So, changes. Imo i-delete ang letter C. Imo sa bilugan danay kag tahi. Dayon, ang letter S naman, pwede mo man sa bilugan kag tahi. So, wala dira. No? So, it's a prank. Okay, next. Delete word and bridge over. For example, dira, reorient our inet values. So, dapat, hindi na ka magbutang sang inet values. Kaya ang inet, that is an adjective. So, remember, when we are writing for the news, okay, dapat, ma-avoid kita sang mga adjectives. So, bago ako malipat. Maghatag gani sinyo sang test paper sa copy reading, i-assess ninyo kung ang ginahatag sa inyo nga test paper o ang article nga ginahatag sinyo news, speech news, feature or editorial. Okay. So dayon lantawon yun dira kung may author ang nagsulat sang news. Diba naghatag ka mo sang inyo nga copy reading marks or instructions sa inyo nga slug lines? Now, ang ginabutang dira nga pangalan, hindi imo. Kundi ang pangalan sang nagsulat sang news sa slug line. Okay? Tandaan nyo na ha, hindi imo pangalan. Diba nagabutang kita dira sa itong slug line or printer's direction? Nagabutang kita dira sang first three words sang aton nga headline. For example, J. Blancaflor nanalo sa loto. Okay. First three words sang imo isulat. J. Blancaflor nanalo. Dayon sa idalom sina, sino ang nagsulat sina nga news? So for example, ako abi contestant, ako hindi ko yung magbutang nga Mark Julius Fentes kaya ako ang contestant. Hindi. Ang nagsulat galiya sang news is si May Gailan. So, ibutang mo dira sa idalom nga Gailan, dayon May. Dayon sa idalom sina, san o gin-publish ina nga news? Hindi ya nga kung san o ikaw nag-copy read. Pero in the event sa track and field, in the event abi nga wala dira sang pangalan sang author kag wala man pangalan or naka-indicate ang date kung saan nagisulat ang news, that's the only time nga ibutang mo imo pangalan nga nag-copy read kag kung saan o mo inaging copy read. Okay, gets? So kung mag-delete kita sang inet dira, aton ilinyahan ang inet nga word, doon bridge over. Next, the teacher. So gusto mo mag-insert sang word nga new. So mabutang ka lang sang tantananan na muna. Do balay-balay si dalom, dayon sa ibabaw, ibutang mo ang word nga gusto ni mo ibutang new, the new teacher. Next, may ara naman dira kung kis a life new. No, kay nakinapoy na si Ma'am Nelsa, nalimtan niya naman niya nagbaliskad ang iyang life new kay iya laminya, new life. So kung nagbaliskad, i-transpose mo lang. Na daw infinity bala, halin ka si Dalom, masaka ka si Babaw, kadto ka naman si Dalom, masaka ka lang si Babaw. Yan daw feeling mo ba lang ginapaasa, kadto yun wala malang gali, nan muna siya mag-transpose. Next, delete letter or letters within. In the word repentance, we have there double T and A. So, i-delete lang natin. Mag-delete kita. Magiging na tahion mo lang ang duwa ka letter kag nan. I-bridge over mo naman liwat. Next, salvation. So, nakitaan mo lah. No, nun yung balita yaw. Damo-damo yasang space. Ang salvation niya dapat dikit. So, may solution na. Mr. Sob tayo. So, ang magiging matabo si na is, i-close up mo lang. Halin si Babaw, kag si Dalom. And, kung di makita nyo na si Babaw si Dalom, may Babaw pagid para i-close up naton. Next, indent material. Mag-indent material kita, wala sa dasang indention, no? Butangan mo lang sang big letter L. Next, set in italic type. Ang punto de vista, di ba, foreign na siya nga word. Tandaan natin, other than Filipino or English, pwede na siya natin ma-identify as foreign nga words or terms. So, imo brahon, mabutang ka lang sang waveline. Next, broad daylight. For example, labi, nagsala ikaw. Man nagbutang kasi niyo, nagimbutangan mo sang na gin-delete ni mo ang day. Hay, hindi ka naka-erase, kay delete na lang ang submission. So, butangan mo lang sang step. S-T-E-T. Dayon imo, circulan. Again, step. S-T-E-T. Okay, dayon circulan. Lain ang step, lain ang scam. Ha? So, stat kita ya ma-focus. S-T-E-T in the S-C-A-M. No? X na sa X. Next, ang Juan de la Serna. So, kung imo i-judge, hala sir, wrong spelling, iyaya nga Juan. So, hindi pwede. Okay? Kaya ang Juan niya sir, J-U-A-N. Pero paglanta mo ya sa iya nga birth certificate, muna gidyang spelling sang iyang Juan, H-U-W-A-N de la Serna. So, base islan ini ni Ma'am Nelsa. So, gani akon inibutangan sang box. So, most probably, children, kung mag-contest ka mo sa copy reading, kundi usually may mga tao, pangalan da sang tao nga hindi sikat, no? So, base islan, ang technique sina, butangan mo ng box. Technique. Butangan ninyo sang mga markings ang halos tanan ng mga words na feeling ninyo sala. Kay nga man, pwede na siya ma-count as mistake. Tandaan, padamu-damu, pangita, sala. For example, ang imo abi dira topic is about face-to-face a learning scheme. In the next school year. The yun may nakasulat nila yung mabuhay ang wikang pambansa nga naka big letter tanan-tanan. Ang mabuhay ang wikang pambansa imo danay pangitaan sala. So i-copy read mo danay kay imo pang small letter, then ipang big letter mo ang mabuhay kay first word siya, ang letter M. Dayon, imo siya dayon i-X tanan-tanan. Kay isip pa adto ang points ni mo ngagin, ubra nga sala nga marking sa ila. So gets? Next, run in copy. Dira o makita nyo, it was decided by the group na? So ang the group pwede pala siya isugpon no sa bangko nga nagani lagating ni Ma'am Chini. So dira makita pa nimo diya nga it was decided by the group, ang the group makaigo padaya sa bay. Subutangan mo lang sang kurit kung diin nag-agi ang helicopter. Ah, dira ang isugpon ang the group sabay. So run in copy ina siya. Next, the road to greatness. So ginlantaw ni mo wala sang sugpon. No, anong sugpon sini? What's the continuation of this news? And then you try to find the continuation back page or the next page or perhaps at the bottommost part of the page, pero wala. So butangan mo lang sang more. M-O-R-E, dayon, imo butangan sang circle, more. Okay, next. Nan, di ba naka-align sa tanan-tanan sa left? So, butangan mo lang sang muna nga daw bracket when you'd like to move text to the right. And kung gusto mo naman i-move text to the left, butangan mo naman sila nga bracket. And kung gusto mo i-align sila nga magtupong, butangan mo sa right. And kung gusto mo lang butangan sang gusto mo naman sila itupong sa left margin, then duwa naman ka line. Now, kunwari tapos ka na sang imo nga contest, do sigurado ka na gidya nga madaog ka na gidya nga maperdi na gidya si Ma'am Nelsa, ikaw na gidya ang ma-champion. So butangan mo lang sang hashtag sa pinakakatapusan nga word, hashtag or 30 nga my circle, pili ka lang dira sa duwa. Hindi mo pwede pagdunganon ang duwa, kay dapat isa lang. Kay kung duwa, damo masakitan. Kung isa lang, sigurado ka nga inaksa masadyahan. No? Now, paano sir mag-insert sang punctuations? All over the news, may mga 'di ba? Nag-expect ako kung anong masunod. So ako na blanco man, no? Dapat butangan mo dayon sang punctuation kung anong sugpon sina, kung din ka mabutang period, kung din ka mabutang colon, kung din ka mabutang semicolon. So kung gusto mo magbutang period, hala o, butangan mo lang sang pintok dayon, circulan mo. Ang colon, butangan mo duwa ka X. Instead ng duwa ka pintok, himuon mo sa X. No, kay ang X tapos na. No, semicolon mo naman X kag comma man. Exclamatory point. Hala, makita nyo man sa screen. Kulit danay, dayon X. Ang kama, do balay-balay sa idalom, dayon kama lang or kudlit. Ang question mark, question and the hook, dayon X-man. Opening quote, on do balay-balay nga baliskad, dayon the opening quote symbol. Sa closing quote, amumana, do balay-balay nga baliskad, dayon closing quote. Apostrophe, balay-balay nga gamay nga may apostrophe, ang parenthesis the same man, ang hyphen gamay lang, ang dash dako nga kulit. So that's it. Now, moving on. We have here the unit headlines for headlining. So tanan-tanan nga mga letra nga makit-an sa headline or sa title sang imo news ginapalitikan ulo. So, dapat hindi magsubra sa 40 to 60 units ang isa ka headline. Kay kung magsubra, gutok-gutok na sila dahil hindi na sila diraya kaigo. So, kung may mas dako pag-diraya sa akin yung mga word o nanong pamandira, dako gina siya nga problema. Gani, ishorten ni mo kung in case gapalanubra ang imo nga unit value sang imo nga headlines. Ang solusyon, Mone. Aton lagpaton ang unit value. Ang small letters nga J-I-L-T-F, mga niwang ina sila, niwang pa kay Ma'am Jinky, no? Mga gagmay na sila, 0.5 lang na sila. The same man sang number 1, niwang man na siya. So, 0.5 man na siya. Tanan nga mga punctuation marks, pero sa isang period, comma, na 0.5 man na siya. Sang una, children, ang spaces between words, no, 0.5 na siya. Pero subong, nag-level up na. No? Kung ang scam nag-level up, ang space nag-level up man. So, hindi na siya 0.5 subong, kundi 1 point na gid siya. Upod niya ang most lowercase letters, nga, for example, A, B, C, D, E, G, H, K-O-P-Q, na tanan dala, except sa J-I-L-T-F, kag M-W nga small letter. Most numerals, ketungod 1 lang ang 0.5, next na 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, 1 na sa nailang nga value. Ang punctuations like question mark, double quotes, and parenthesis, no 1 point man na sila upod sa nag-level up nga space, 1 point man. Now, dire kita sa 1.5. Ining si M iniho, kag si W nga small letters, 1.5 din na sila. Kaya ara na sila sa ilang nga progress to obesity. No? So, daw kasakit, no? Kung imo i-mention ina nga word, pero nga man gin-mention akon, no? So, daw may gakulit, gid. Okay, M kag W. So, matulot ang book. To pagid, masakit pagid. No? Kamu na lang sinadala sugpon. So, tungod do medyo muna na na sa 1.5 ang iya nga value. Kag halos tanan nga mga capital letters, except sang big letter M, kag big letter W, nga mga dalagko man. Panindigan ta na lang ni. Pati ang dash, 1.5 man. Pero ining big letters nga M kag W, tungod malapad gid siniya, ilang nga ginakonsume nga space, 2 gid sinaya, 2 points, or 2 units gid sinaya ang ilang nga equivalent. So next. Now, what is a headline? Ang headline is a telegraphic sentence summary of the news. Kung gusto ko man tanin, makita ko sa TV, galing hindi ko yung makita sa TV. Pati na. Okay, the headline should match with the lead. Okay, dapat ang aton headline magpariho gid sa lead. Diba, aton hambal kagaina, ang aton nga title, dira ta makita sa lead. So for example, dira, the Department of Education or DepEd Secretary Brother Armin Luistro sent a letter yesterday to Iloilo Division Office congratulating it for outstanding performance in the 2014 National Achievement Test. O, diba? Gusto mo gid na nga makita ka sa TV. O, ara, antos kita sang gagmay. Okay. So, tungod mabase kita sang aton nga headlines, aton nga lead. So, nagapati kita sang SVO pattern. Tandaan mga bata, ha? Mag-ubra kita sang aton nga headline. Nag-follow kita sang SVO O pattern. Ano ang nag-stand sang S? Ano ang butsinigon sang S? Very good mga bata. Ang S ay nangangahulugang subject. Ano naman ang verb? Verb na siya, V na siya. Diba? Ginambal ko lang, no? Lutang din tayo kung minsan. At ang O naman ay object. So, S, V, O, mauna na lang si subject. So, dira sa aton nga lead, the Department of Education or DepEd Secretary Brother Armin Luistro sent a letter yesterday to Iloilo Division Office congratulating it for its outstanding performance in the 2014 National Achievement Test. So, dira, ano ang subject? Magaling. Okay, ang inyong mga kasagutan ay tama, Luistro. So, si Luistro ang subject kasi siya ang doer of the action. Anong iyang action dira? Ginano niya? Nag-ano siya? Nag-congratulate. So, instead of writing congratulating, kaya masyado siya kahaba, imo siya islan nga maglipot siya para ma-budget mo ang imo nga unit value. So, LODS. Kasi si Luistro singular subject, LODS singular verb. Dayon, oh, LODS what? DepEd Iloilo for tapping not for. Next. Okay, the headline must have a subject and a verb in the present tense. So, dapat ang headline, may araman subject, kag verb, kag sa present tense na siya, dapat na base. Okay, sala na siya kung maghambal ka nga bagged national awards, kay bawal past tense. It should be Gomez bags National Awards. Next, do not use a period. Bawal magsulat sang period sa headline ha o sa title ha. No period allowed in headlines. Next, minimize punctuation marks. So, hindi kita magpinabuang kag pinagusto gamit sang punctuation marks. Use single quotation marks. Use a comma in place of end. So, meaning, bawal gali ang end. bawal magsulat sang end sa title and a semicolon to separate sentences. So, dapat gamit ka lang sang comma kung gusto mo magsulat sang end. So, sala ina kung ma-write ikaw sa imo headline sang rolling stores to sell garlic and onion. But it will be correct if you say rolling stores to sell garlic, onion. Kaya ang comma dura serves as and. Bawal man magamit sang articles nga a, an, kag the. So, sala ina kung maghamba ka nga a fire hits Santa Barbara bypass road. So, dapat, diretso ka na. Fire hits Santa Barbara bypass road. Next. Do not use names unless the person is well-known or recognized for an achievement. So, kagaina katungod si Luistro, for example, no, for example, mabakada, Fuentes lectures about journalism. Hay sino yun? Si Fuentes, hindi mako sikat-sikat, gid. Hindi mako national icon, hindi mako leading person like sa itong mga politicians or the president. So, mahambal ka lang nga teacher lectures about John. Muna lang. So, for example, dili kita sa use. No, di ba nag-ano-ano kita, no? Do mga pangyayari na. Wrong ina dala maghambal kita nga Rivera dies in car mishap. So kay si Rivera hindi ni siya sang sikat, no? So isla mo sang businessman dies in a car mishap. Next. So use infinitive for future events. So sala kung maghambal ka nga principal is going to push teachers move policy. Sala ina siya. Pero correct kung maghambal ka nga principal to push teachers move policy. Bawal ikaw nga mag is going to, are going to, kundi magamit ikaw infinitive nga nagagamit sang to kag base form sang verb. Next. Use specific terms instead of generalities. No, mas specify ikaw kung ano sinugid na siya. For example, sala kung maghambal ikaw nga school official gets thumbs up. Okay, or chin or jinky stand up. So sala, no? Correct na siya kung principal gets thumbs up. Okay, next. Headlines must have a complete thought. It must capture the whole form and complete idea. So, students award best mentor on Teacher's Day. So, time check, it's 12 na, no? Pakuno-kuno lang kamuda nga nagapamati kamu kay hindi ko man kamu kita kung nagakauna kamuda. Gani, enjoy your lunch while listening to Sir Mark. Next. Example, or use catchy, short, absolute, and specific words to show action and color. Every word is important. Use as many facts in a few words as possible. For example, Typhoon Kuring, lashes Leyte. Avoid opinions or interpretations. Bawal, ikaw gidira iya maghatag sang imo yung description. So, sala na siya maghambal ka nga angered group of teachers go on strike. Sigurado ka gid. Nga akig-akig gid sila. Okay, that's a wrong way nga pag-describe sa mga teachers kay basang ibang sila yan napilitan mo lang. No, hindi makakahambal nga angered group gid. But it will be correct if you specify it as 500 teachers go on strike. Okay? Next. Avoid unintentional double meanings. Example, debating team fails. Advisor takes over. Huh? So, naperdi ang debating team dayon ang advisor na lang ang nag-contest? So, ano gid siya? No, next. Avoid beginning with a verb, preposition, article, or conjunction. It will turn the headline into a command which results in a negative meaning. So, bawal ikaw magbutang sang verb sa pinakauna-una gid as first word. Or bawal ikaw maghambal sang preposition sa first word or article or conjunction. So, kung maghambal ka nga, throw your garbage properly. By principal. So, bawal na siya. Kahit throw your garbage properly, mambaka, buwaw, sugi-sugi nila principal ba? Pala sugo ba? Okay, next. Quit smoking. DOH. Next. Using the verb form to be makes the headline weak. So use more appropriate verb. So it is wrong when you say Duterte to be at Wivraa opening. So Duterte to grace Wivraa opening. So dapat to grace, wala na dira sang mga to be. Okay, next. The suffix ing form of the verb should only be used if the events are presently happening. So example, teachers hoping for salary hike. Okay, or campus journalists of Rojas City attending conference. Next, days of the week in the headline should be abbreviated. So DepEd declares Friday no assignment day. Next. So the use of number in the headline should only be done if the situation calls for it. Example, 105 freshmen to attend summit. So kung kinanglan gid number in figure gid. Month should not only be abbreviated if it has an exact date. So for example, sina SDS declares November 10 as free day. So tungod ang November may number siya nga kasunod, i-shorten mo na lang siya. NOV na lang siya, NOV 10. Pero kung wala siya sang number nga kasunod sina, i-spell out mo gid November. Next. Single quote marks must be used instead of double quote marks. So another pride for us, says high school principal. Next. Do not split a verb phrase na kung mga two kita nga mga columns, no, two line headlines, like priest, nuns to visit youth camp. So araya si dalum ang verb. So dapat isugpon mo sang two kag ang base form sang verb. Dapat priest, nuns to visit youth camp. Next, don't divide a preposition and its object. So the same thing applies. It is wrong when you say freshman gains praises for act of heroism, but it will be correct if you say freshman gains praises for act of heroism. Okay, next. Do not split an adjective and the noun it modifies. So it is wrong, teachers to hold pizza party on February 14. Like, diri, no? Nag-penalty na kami. Okay. Next. Do not separate names that belong together. For example, UNESCO Awards dyan, dayon gin-enter mo, Lloyd Cruz, as, dayon gin-enter mo naman, Youth of the Year. Kundi, diretsoon mo ang pagsulat sa mga pangalan. Dapat diretso ang first name to ang last name. It will be then, UNESCO Awards John Lloyd Cruz as Youth of the Year. Next. Use abbreviations only if they are well known. When initials are used, do not use spaces or periods between letters. For example, PAGASA declares red alert or Pinoy Graces Brigada 2015. So mga abbreviations lang ganyan mga sikat, no? PAGASA and Pinoy. Okay, next. If the verb is in the passive mood, for example, a Shabu lab was or is discovered in Iloilo City. So ang headline niya siya na Shabu lab discovered in Iloilo. Be verb is omitted. So wala na kita nagagamit sang is or was. Direct quotation as heads. So saan o kita sir? Ate yung magida, children. Amo na siya ang pinaka-importante sa tanan nyo nga mabalaan. Magamit sang direct quotation as headlines. So damo-damo sini usually taga contest nagasalala, gasalala set, no? Okay. So dapat magamit kita sini sang kung gusto niya direct quotations aton gamiton, gagamit kita sang dash, no? For example, I will increase the salary of teachers dash Duterte. Number 2, the use of colon. So mabutang ka lang una gid kung sinong nagambal sina Duterte colon I will increase the salary of teachers. Or third, using narrative form. So kung duhaba-haba gid ang space kag kung one liner lang gid ang ginapangita, pwede ka nga I will increase the salary of teachers says Duterte. Next. If possible, do not be in the negative. So it is wrong when you say Dinagyang Festival won't be held. Pero pwede ka man kambang Dinagyang Festival cancelled. Next. So kung ikaw sa Filipino pag-uulo ng balita, ulo ng balita ang tawag sa pamagat ng balita. Ito ay nakalimbag sa mas malalaking tipo ng titik kaysa sa teksto nito at isinusulat sa pormang pa-telegrama. Sa Ingles, ang pandiwa sa ulo ng balita ay laging nasa panahunang pangkasalukuyan kahit ang balita ay naganap na. So present tense managyapon pareho sa English. So sa Filipino, ang pandiwang gagamitin ay umaangkop sa panahuna ng pangyayari sa balita. Pangnagdaan kung naganap na, pangkasalukuyan kung nangyayari pa, at panghinaharap kung magaganap pa lamang. So mga bagay na dapat tandaan sa pag-uulo ng balita, so the same man dito kagaina sa ngaton nga ginhambal, so the same man. Next. Huwag paghiwali ng mga tambalan o mga salitang magkakaugnay. So muna man, drug lords tipok kay Duterte, dapat ang drug lords sugpon mo, hindi mo pag-i-enter na, hindi mo pag-i-separate kag i-divide. Next. Gamitin ang kuwit bilang pamalit sa at. So, plus man nakagayin niya sa end bala, so kama man gihapon. So, next. Huwag bumanggit ng pangalan maliban kung ang tao ay kilala. So, mali ang Bilbao, kampiyon sa Microsoft Global Award. So, kinakailangan mong itama ito. So, since si Bilbao hindi siya sikat, ihambal mo na lang Pinoy, kampiyon sa Microsoft Global Award. Next. Iwasan ang opinyon sa ulo ng balita, the same inada kagaina sa ginmention nakon. Next. Iwasan ang masaklaw na pagpapahayag. So, kung sa news, bawal kaya maghambang Region 6 bumandila sa paligsahan. So, doon ka OA na siya, doon pang sports writing na siya. So, tama na siya kung maghambang ka nga Region 6 Broadcasting bumandila sa NSPC 2016. Mali pag sinabi mo na palarong pambansa hindi natuloy, kundi palarong pambansa ipinagpaliban. So, muna dapat. Next. Wala na sang next. So, tapos na si Sir Mark. So, thank you so much for listening.